record. Praise the Lord, brothers and sisters. Brother John, watch me for that great day. Brother Brian, how are you? And Brother Aaron, God bless you. Who else is there, Brother Aaron?
Brother Aaron.
Who else?
With me?
Yes.
Who? Jesus. Oh, Enrico. Yeah.
Enrico.
Too. Yeah.
Hello. How you guys doing? You guys ready to fly? I'm ready to fly.
I love that character. That's a great character.
He's one of the
funny.
Best.
Well, he's funny. Well, I like the pot on your head, Brother Aaron.
The bottle?
The pot.
Oh, yeah. You saw that one? Yeah. Oh, yeah. My goodness. Sometimes I record myself and I say, what did I just do? But you know
what? I saw
what?
It on your head. I'm like, man, he's got some wiggle room.
Yeah. Right. But you know, we all need to smile a little bit right now, as we all know. Yeah. And
absolutely,
it's so dark. We need a little bit of laughter before we fly. So
that's right. And keep the
faith. Keep the faith.
That's right.
And Jesus is Lord, and go Jesus go, and come Jesus, and even so come Lord Jesus. And sisters, you know what? The Bible says that laughter is a good medicine. It's as medicine to the joints and the bones, right? So so we try to keep a joy even in all the darkness and the terrible things going on in the world. The video I made earlier was it was heavy. I had a hard time holding it together. But we know all the things that are going on in the world. There's no reason to over focus on these things. What we're focusing on is the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, and that is imminent. It is imminent. It is imminent. It is any moment. It can happen today, tomorrow, the next day, next week. Here we go. There's another brother that I want to introduce to you, and here he is right here on the phone. Hold on.
Drum roll.
Second. Brother Donnie Donnelly, right?
Brother John.
All right. You're on the air. We're doing a video, and Brother Brian is here, and Brother Aaron.
All right.
So I wanna start off with what you told me, because I want your piece. This is so amazing with what you called me directly after watching my video this morning, and what you said, and I just want the guys to listen to you, and go ahead, take it from here. Just, you can tell me the whole story, right? Go ahead.
Yeah.
All right. So like I've been talking to you for years, back in 2017, like in the beginning, right before I went to sleep, I heard it's a 7-day event, and I seen a silhouette of a man and woman kissing. That was like back in 2017. I've been like holding on to it. Where does it fit? You know, when you know that you hear something and get something, you know you got it. And then in like 2019, again, I heard Tuesday, the sun will rise in the darkness.
And all right, hold it right there. Hold it right there.
This a bunch of times.
I know. Hold it right there. Tuesday, the sun will rise in the darkness. I'm just emphasizing what you said, because it's a little low, but we can still hear you. Go ahead.
Okay. So, you know, and you can confirm that I've been telling you that for a few years, right?
Oh, yeah.
I told you this over and over, and it's like, where does it fit? Where does it go? And then when you made the video, and it just so happened that the 24th is a Tuesday, the 31st is a Tuesday, and it's a 7 days.
24.
Then, like I told you, to also what I told you is that a few years ago, I seen the study of the dove in the Noah, the dove, right? The dove, when Noah lets the dove go and he doesn't return, the study showed that it was the 23rd of Elul. And if Torah's right, or if we're a month, I don't know, but it just so happened that the 31st is the 23rd of Elul.
The 31st of August is the 23rd of Elul. Also, that is the day, the 23rd of Elul, that the Twin Towers were hit 20 years ago.
Wow.
And 7 days later from that day was Rosh Hashanah, brothers and sisters.
Yep. So the thing is, does it all fit? I don't know. It just so happened there's too many things that just so happened. I mean, I don't know.
All right. So thank you, Donnie. Let me just share the, go ahead. I'll let you go, Bob, but Brother Brian, hold on a second. So Tuesday, so the 24th, which is when the video was made, the one that I shared this morning with the briefing, and they came out of the briefing and right into the media room, which was, they only allowed 90 minutes to give out their,
right, yeah,
you know, that was made on a Tuesday. Tuesday following is the 31st of August. That is the deadline that Biden has set for it, for them, for our troops and everyone out of Afghanistan. The video I made this morning was about God's judgment. And I connected it to the days of Noah just by saying that it was just as the days of Noah, and there were eight people on the ark, and it was a 7-day warning that Noah received. Okay.
Right. And God closed the ark's door 7 days prior to the flood.
That's right. And so, but the door is not closed yet for anybody that needs to be to come in, because these are the last days and anything can happen before 7 days from now.
Just one more, Lord.
One more. That's right. And more than one, Lord. Just bring them in, right? Shine that
thousands on thousands, Lord.
Amen. Amen. So the whole thing that you just said there, brother, Tuesday, the sun will rise in the darkness. While he was saying this to me, brother Brian and Aaron, before, he was so excited. He says he was waiting for me, that whole 31-minute video I did, to tell people exactly what he had just said, because I had forgotten. He reminded me, Tuesday, the sun rises in the darkness. As he's telling me this over the phone, I'm going, oh my God, God just gave me the riddle, because what does that mean, the sun rises in the darkness? I said, this is what it means. The sun rises in the east and sets in the west. It rises in the east, sets in the west. The sun will rise in darkness. What do you think the 31st of August is? That's a dark day. It's going to rise in darkness. Is that our day? Is that the rapture time? I don't know, but I'm saying, we're just so close, brothers and sisters, to something happening, and we know it. We feel it in every fiber of our being, and we're painting. We're feeling sickly. We're not no reason for inflammation and tingling in fingers and you name it. People are telling me this and writing me email upon email about, you know, pray for this one and pray for that one. And are you taking the jab? No, I'm not taking the jab. The whole deal here is we're in a moment of time where we suspect, we not only suspect, but we expect the Lord to come at any moment. Right, Brother Aaron?
So the interesting thing here with this whole August 31st thing that you just mentioned is, this morning I was making the connection, and through a different way, because I believe we are a month off, and I believe we're in the month of Av right now.
Okay.
And so what I've done was I took the Genesis story in the ninth of Av being August 17th.
And the reason you come to that is because of where Feast of Weeks was, right? And that was April, goes back to like April 19th, and you count, and right? So that's kind of
there. So basically the most important thing is April 13th being day one, Nisan 1, day one. And because the Torah calendar declared the beginning of the year before the spring equinox, that's one thing. And so they were too early. You can't declare the beginning of the year until after the spring equinox. Yeah. So that's one thing. Number two, the sun should be in Aries to declare the beginning of the year. And number three, it's got something to do with the Abib star in Virgo, which is basically at the complete opposite of Aries and coming to the plane. Yes. And so it makes sense at the beginning of the year is when the sun's coming up, the Abib star is coming down, right? In perfect conjunction. So those three things kind of confirm the beginning of the year. So having said that, now if I'm wrong, I'm wrong. But a lot of people believe this concept. The beginning of the year should start after the spring equinox. So having said that, we're in the month of Av, if that's what you believe, and that's what I believe. And so 9th of Av would have been the ninth day of the fifth month, which was approximately August 17th, because months start at the new moon, the black moon. A full moon is not the new moon. A full moon is in the middle of the month, and a new moon is when you see the first sliver of the black moon. Anyway, people say that Genesis 8 verse 6 is the ninth of Av. So if you add 14 days to that, because the dove was released, came back, and then it was released again, but it did not come back. That's the punchline here. It did not come back. It
did not come back. That's the key.
Verse 12, Genesis 8, verse 12, it was sent out 14 days after the ninth of Av, and it did not come back. Well, 14 days after ninth of Av is approximately August 30th, 31st. Now, that would mean the true Feast of Trumpets is in October, October 7th and 8th. Give or take, because on the Torah calendar, it's, I think it's September 6, 7, correct me if I'm wrong, but the Torah count, I mean, the true calendar, it would be October 7, 8. Well, you minus 40 days from that Feast of Trumpets,
right?
You get to August 30th, 31st.
Ah.
And that's, we have lots of 40-day warnings, right? Jonah had 40-day warning, right?
Yeah, that's right.
So if it's not a rapture on August 30th or 31st,
it's something.
It wouldn't be a miss to say maybe it's a warning on
maybe it's a maybe it's a maybe it, I had a sister I have a sister from we all have a sister this sister her name is Marcia Clark. She's from Florida, and she's always telling me that there's going to be this great revival and the outpouring of God's spirit, and God's going to do something. And she gave me a scripture earlier that I have to read, because we're talking in such manner as this. Let me just go there, bring it up. First of all, she told me to read Psalms 97, and let me just see something real quickly. And she also told me Psalms 37:10. Let me just do that real quick. 37:10. But she's under the idea that there's going to be a great revival, which, hey, I'm for anything that God does. Are you not? Are you guys for anything yes. that God does? Yeah. I mean, ultimately,
of course, yeah.
Ultimately, course. Whatever He does, that's all we're looking for. let him do whatever He's going to do, but let Him do something so that we are the beneficiaries of it, of such a thing. If He's going to pour out His Spirit and there's a 40-day period before the rapture, that's fine too. Okay. Yeah. Because yeah, we're going to be the beneficiaries, right? We're going to be the beneficiaries of what God does. And this is exciting, brothers and sisters. So anyway, Sister Marcia sent me this. She told me to go to and read it in the Passion Translation. And it speaks this. And I got to read both of these. It's Psalms 37, 10 and 11. And it says, just a little while longer. It's like a word from the Lord. She's hearing this. Just a little while longer. Sounds like those that are underneath the altar, you know, crying out, how Lord, how long, O Lord, right? In Revelation 6, 9 through 11. Yeah. Just a little while longer, and the ungodly will vanish. The ungodly will vanish. That means not like a rapture. Okay. That means like, you know, perish. Okay.
Yeah.
God's going to move them out of the way. He's going to cause, you know, there's going to be destruction. You will look for them in vain, but the humble of heart will inherit every promise and enjoy abundant peace. Now, how do you like that for a word? Now, remember Psalm 37, the whole psalm, but I'm not going to read the whole psalm. I'm going to read 97. This is in the Passion Translation, in the gateway, you know, application here. So here it is. You guys don't mind me reading this. This is going to be an awesome thing.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah. Yeah, please do.
Don't follow after the wicked ones or be jealous of their wealth. Don't think for a moment they're better off than you. How many of us have been jealous, right, of things? That's part of our nature, you know. Oh, man, I wish I had that. They and their short-lived success will soon shrivel up and quickly fade away like grass clippings in the hot sun. Keep trusting in the Lord and do what is right in His eyes. Fix your heart on the promises of God, and you will dwell in the land, feasting on His faithfulness. Find your delight, the true pleasure of Yahweh, and He will give you what you desire the most. Give, what do we desire the most, brothers and sisters? Jesus, come, yeah. Lord Jesus, that's our desire. Give God the right to direct your life. There it is. That's what I said in my earlier one, the Psalm, Proverbs 3:3-5 there. Lean not to your own understanding, but God, give the right, give God the right to direct your life. Turn it over, brothers and sisters. And as you trust him along the way, you'll find he pulled it off perfectly. He will appear as your righteousness, as sure as the dawning of a new day. He will manifest as your justice, as sure as and strong as the noonday sun. Quiet your heart in his presence and wait patiently for Yahweh. We have waited patiently. We are still waiting patiently. Yahweh is coming, brothers and sisters. His name is Jesus, God with us, Emmanuel. He's coming, brothers and sisters. And don't think for a moment that the wicked in their prosperity are better off than you. Stay away from anger and revenge. Keep envy far from you, for it only leads into lies. For one day the wicked will be destroyed, but those who trust in the Lord will inherit the land. Isn't that what we're looking for? Just a little while longer, here it comes again, and the ungodly will vanish. Oh, this, you know what? This is the whole Psalm 37. I meant to read something else, Psalm 97. But anyway, I read the whole Psalm 37, so this is just as good.
Hey, Brother John, can you pull up another? Yeah. Can you pull up another verse?
Yeah.
Okay, it's out there, but this just came to me. Can you pull up Enoch 1:1?
Oh, Enoch 1:1?
Yeah.
All right, Enoch chapter 1.
Yeah.
Enoch.
Mr. Enoch got taken out before the flood, folks.
Yes.
So why not? Why not investigate a little bit of his history?
Yeah, let's see what Enoch's got to say. The book of Enoch, here we go, chapter 1, here we go. What, the first verse of it or what?
Yeah, one, first verse.
All right, here we go, brothers and sisters. Enoch, the words of the blessing of Enoch, wherewith he blessed the elect. Does that sound like what we're reading here, brother?
Yeah.
All right. And righteous, who will be living in the day of tribulation, when all the wicked and godless are to be removed. And he took up his parable and said, Enoch, a righteous man whose eyes were opened by God, saw the vision of the Holy One in the heavens, which the angels showed me. And from them I heard everything and found them. And from them I understood as I saw, but not for this generation, but for a remote one, which is for to come. That's this generation, brothers and sisters.
Yeah.
Concerning the elect, I said, and took up my parable concerning them. So is that's where you want me? That's like the third verse all the way.
Yeah. Through. Yeah. That was good, Brother John. Yeah.
So, yeah. So this is all tying in, brothers and sisters, to how close are we? I mean, honestly, even though we haven't pinpointed a day and saying, you know, this is absolutely it, because we've tried and done that. We've tried and done all that. Even Brother Barry Orr.
Yeah.
And more to come, you know.
Yeah.
Thing is, we're all watching. We're all praying for each other. We're all lifting up each other. We're all offering whatever we can offer to each other through emails, you know, through prayers, finances, whatever.
But even if we, you know, we have these target dates.
Yeah.
When the rapture can happen. Well, right. You know, if they don't come to pass on a certain day,
don't get to
it's for our benefit still.
Yes.
Because it's what we were called to do, to watch.
That's right.
I'm going to read one more verse, too.
I was going to say this earlier, Brother Aaron, that Brother John and I, we had a talk together with Bob Hagen. And I made a comment, and I want to address that again, just a short comment that, you know, we have the armor of God, and the armor of God is a spiritual armor. And it's this armor that he has given us. The world has their armor, but our armor that was given to us from God, no weapon will prosper against the armor, yeah. our armor that's been provided from our Lord and Savior, our King and King. He rides before us in battle, and he always wins, hands down.
Amen. But,
you know, it's just so much that we hear, but to our eyes are going to bust open one of these days shortly. I feel like everybody's watching, it's going to be like a light bulb moment.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, because we are the children of light.
Yeah.
And it's going to happen.
Amen.
Hey, I'm looking forward to it. Tell you at the same time, I'm kind of scared of it because we'll realize things that we never had an idea would happen.
Yeah, it'll be a quick, you won't be afraid though, because God will give you in that moment, ultimate peace. You won't, no one's going to be afraid when they're raptured out of here. It's not going to be like, oh, I have fear of heights, oh, you know?
Yeah, so addressing the armor of God, you know, the world has their body armor, riot police, and all this sort of thing, whatever, and our military, but that is still a corruptible armor, just like our flesh is corruptible. But when we are changed in a twinkling of an eye,
yeah.
not only are we going to be incorruptible, but our armor is as well.
Go ahead, Brother Aaron.
Oh, yeah. Well, you brought up Enoch, Brother Brian. And so it's interesting how Enoch was brought up in, I think it's chapter 5, verse 24 in Genesis. But it's he was also mentioned in Jude, the book just before Revelation, right? So that's in Jude 1:14. Now, Enoch was the seventh from Adam, prophesied about these men, also saying, behold, the Lord comes with 10,000 of his saints. But if we go back to Hebrews 11, this is all by faith, by faith, by faith. And I'm just going to read two verses, verses 5 and 6 in chapter 11. By faith, Enoch was taken away so that he did not see death and was not found because God had taken him. For before he was taken, he had this testimony that he pleased God. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he who comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, so Enoch is kind of a type and shadow of us right now, taken away.
Yeah.
Like John the Baptist, you know, he was already in the wilderness crying out to a lost world. Yeah. You know, and he said, he looked up and said, behold the Lamb of God. You know, how powerful is that?
Brother, can I, you know, just something just popped into my head. The voice of John in the wilderness, interesting, because that was the beginning of the church, and that was as Christ came the first time. You know, yeah. especially into his ministry.
Yeah.
And now at the end, it's the voice of the bride crying in the wilderness.
Just like when Mary went to hit her to Elizabeth, she was expecting with yeah. John the Baptist. Mary shows up, she also is expecting, yeah. and John the Baptist leaped in Elizabeth's womb.
Yeah.
Just that connection. They hadn't even seen each other, but John the Baptist knew he was near. He was there already in the world.
Wow.
Before he was delivered. You know, it's just, wow. And
Hey,
let Brother Donnie still listening. He's still on the phone. Go ahead, Brother Donnie.
Yeah. Well, since you mentioned that and y'all mentioned Enoch, y'all mentioned John the Baptist, and John the Baptist is known of Elijah. Elijah was taken too.
Yes.
Yeah.
And in addition to Elisha, he knew what he was going to be taking because they were having this conversation. Yeah. Hey, before you leave, can you bless me? Because I know you're going to get raptured or whatever.
Double
I know
portion.
You're
going to
get. Yeah. I know you're going to get snatched. Can you give me a double portion? Because okay, you've asked a lot, but yeah, okay. You know, so people say you know it's going to be a complete mystery. There, I think somebody's going to figure it out, and I think it'll be revealed. And I think there's no hurt in watching and looking. And I think it's actually a good thing to watch and look and try and figure it out.
Yeah, we learn a lot, man. We learn so much by watching. We learn all these nuggets.
That's right.
You know what's interesting about Brother Donnie Donnelly? If you guys don't know, brothers and sisters, he's only been a brother in the Lord since like August or just thereabouts of 2017, just prior to all that, right, bro?
Wow.
So he's
July 2017. Yeah.
So he's basically a new believer. And look, God downloaded things into this man.
Yeah,
and
praise God.
He's the guy.
His eyes.
He's the guy I was talking about when I was telling you back when Barry Scarborough and Sister Lisa from Midnight Hour Oil was having all the lemon dreams. He's the guy that found the lemon out in the back of his house when he was raking up.
Yep.
No reason for it.
Just showed up anyway. Yeah, just showed up.
After Shavuot or after
Tabernacles,
right. That year.
It was on October 26, 2017.
Mm, October 26, 2017.
Wow.
Oh, that's cool.
And here we are 4 years roughly from it. He's getting ready to have that anniversary, the 26th of October. Well, praise God that we're not gonna be here for that. Let's hope.
No way.
What?
Yeah.
Could
be in FEMA camp somewhere.
Oh, please, no FEMA camps for anybody. We bind all that. In fact, God is protect. See, people do get fearful of this, but I'm gonna tell you what. How many people that won't take it, you know what I'm talking about? And if that time came, we're supposed to escape that time. You understand that, guys? You guys both know this. Revelation 3:10. We're going to be kept out of that hour.
That hour is
the time of the experiment when they make it and they're starting to make it. Well, that's why we're like saying something's about to happen. We're gauging it off of what current world events are. And here we are.
Brother John, most of the attacks that we get in our personal lives, they're sneak attacks.
Oh, yeah. They come from that.
Always catch you off guard. When you're not looking, sneak attack.
Tired, weak, drink. And it comes in.
Yeah, it's like the old saying, don't let your spirit go through halt. Never go hungry. Never get angry. Never get too lonely. Never get too tempted.
God will always make a way out. That's why
when one door closes, another one, he opens another door. And going back to Enoch, one of that is all these portal kind of thing. When one door closes, a season, time, and then events, and opening new doors for us.
There's a few verses with doors in Revelation as well. And I find that really interesting. There's like four verses in Revelation 3 and 4. Let me just find those verses. So,
Bring
open
them up,
door,
brother.
Door. Okay. So, Church of Philadelphia, it says in verse 3, verse 8, I know your work. See, I have set before you an open door, and no one can shut it. For you have little strength, have kept my word, and have not denied my name. If we go over to Revelation 3, 20 and 21, hello, 2021. Behold, I stand at the door. And knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door. I will come in to him and dine with him, and he with me. To him who overcomes, I will grant to sit with him on my throne, as I also overcame and sat down with my Father, with my Father on his throne. And if we hop over to Revelation 4, verse 1, there's one more door verse in this area. After these things, I looked, and behold, a door standing open in heaven. And the first voice, which I heard, was like a trumpet speaking with me, saying, come up here, and I will show you things which must take place after this. Lots of fun verses with a door there.
What a great connection, Brother Aaron.
Yeah, I've got them all circled and highlighted in that area.
Great connection, brother. Yeah.
Yeah.
And you know, a little further on the Enoch chapter here, just down in the same verse, concerning the elect, I said, and took up my parable concerning them. That's where I left off in the last part. The Holy One will come forth from his dwelling. That ends the third verse of the first. So we got like 10 minutes left here. So we can bring it all into some final thoughts. But I believe that the Lord is soon to come. What do you think?
I do.
Without a doubt.
Brother Donnie, yeah? Everything has purpose in everybody's life. There's something that happens in each one of our lives as far as our faith is concerned, as far as many of us that are out here actually physically walking each day, watching the current events and watching how they line up with what Bible, you know, what the Bible is saying to us, seeing what's happening in Afghanistan, which is creating a vacuum for the Gog Magog war. Absolutely. Yeah. Okay, this is not even a question. How the world is looking at the United States in its weakness. When something is weak, it's easily conquered. The Bible says in Ezekiel, we're not even in there, brothers and sisters. There is no America to come to the aid of Israel. So again, back to the first video that I made today. And, you know, it's always your thoughts and what you see, but this is what we're seeing. And jointly, we're agreeing that the Lord has, you know what, Billy Graham used to say all the time in his last days, last of his crusades and stuff, that God was going to have to judge America. Otherwise, he'd have to apologize to Sodom and Gomorrah. That's famous words, all right?
Yeah, that makes sense, doesn't it? And here, better rods full of child.
And here we are. And look what's happening. And look at the impassioned calls from the men that are military and the people that are hurt that have served for 20 years and brought Afghanistan to a place. And now it's just, you know, there's no reason except for God is allowing things to take place. Remember this, it's not man necessarily saying, oh, you know, we're just going to, God has to allow, always. God has to allow. And when you realize that, you realize that God is definitely doing something to bring his bride out of what is being allowed, which is the tribulation. And that is coming. So.
Yeah. Come out of her. Come out of Babylon.
Yeah. So yeah. Brother Aaron, any final words there, brother?
I've got a question for you and you might not have the answer. I just had a thought. I don't know if it was right now or just today, but Saul, Paul, right? You know, at first he was condemning the Christians and then he kind of flipped, right?
Yeah.
And he became an advocate for Christ. Do you think that's a type and shadow of the tribulation saints?
Type and shadow of the tribulation saints.
Because right now we've got people that are not.
Yeah, that's Jesus. A real good point, brother Aaron.
Listen to Donnie.
Yes, Donnie.
Aaron.
Yeah.
Aaron, it's interesting you say that because both Paul and John the Baptist was beheaded, both of them.
Oh, wow. Yes. Right, really? Okay.
Wow.
Good one, Donnie.
Good call. Yeah.
Go ahead.
Wow.
It kind of supports the church, too, like y'all was saying about the church, you know? I mean, you got bride and you know what I mean?
Yeah. Me too.
I believe there is tons of type and shadows all over the Bible that signify what was will happen again, because that's what it says in Ecclesiastes. And so I just thought about that. You know, there's so many people that are kind of mocking and scoffing, but when we're gone, there are going to be so many people that are going to flip a switch so fast.
Yeah.
It's like their blinders are going to come off, like Saul, you know?
Yeah.
And basically the question is that a type and shadow of the tribulation saints? And it'd be a good study to actually go into.
You know, I just thought of something else. Right now it's the people of the world are under the governments of the world who make the rules and make the laws and all that, and they have to go according to whatever the rules and laws are of that particular government. But one thing is now so obvious that I said this some back in 2020, I said, this thing is the snare that's on the earth. What we're looking at right now is the snare. It's upon the whole earth, not just one government, all governments. So the point is that right now it's people's choice to go along with the government or not. It's still a choice one way or the other. Okay, might be consequences if it gets to a certain point, like in Australia, they're deciding not to go, they're rising up. Well, they could end up in jail and worse, okay? You know, somewhere where the family don't know. This is the whole thing. We're on the verge of literally calling what we're seeing here the tribulation, and yet it's not yet. It's the beginnings of, it's the beginnings of sorrows, if you will.
Brother John,
one thing more, that what we're seeing is now the people can choose to go along with the government or not, but it's still going to remain the same after the rapture. But the people that have chosen to go along with the government of Jesus, see, are waiting to get taken away to be under that government, see?
Yeah.
And then it still remains a choice for those that are here to choose whether they're going to go along or not. And that's the other end of the deal where it's a mark. So we're there, brothers and sisters. Go ahead, brother. Yeah. You can finish up. You've got 3 minutes.
I had a thought, you know, with this, all the things that are being forced on us and these recent approvals, of course, so, you know, probably start making it into, you know, things you have to do unnecessarily. I think that another surprise that I've been thinking about is because they want to reset things for what it's worth, if I can say that, that I think they're going to find patient zero. Patient zero is someone who has cash. I'm going to bring it down to people that use cash. They are spreading that on the cash.
Yeah.
So if we get rid of the cash, we have this reset, then it all goes digital and there you go.
Instant, right? Instantaneous.
Yeah.
Everything's just perfect setup for everything. It's all perfect setup. Like we got to be here. It's so hard to not see it unless there's an intentional blindness or something,
they've already conditioned us to use our debit cards.
Right.
Oh yeah.
You know, not many people even carry pocket change anymore. They don't carry.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
You know, dollars or things. They're using their debit cards or whatever.
Yeah.
You know, so that's already been programmed and works, and it's been ongoing for years and years. So it won't be a shock when that happens. Basically, what I'm trying to say.
That's right. Yeah.
Well. Which one of you want to pray out?
Let's invite Brother Donnelly.
Donnie, why don't you pray us out, brother?
Yeah, brother.
Go ahead.
God, we come together and we thank you for showing us things. We thank you for encouraging us. We thank you for all the blessings and everything, and we just continue to pray for encouragement and support and just everything.
Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name,
amen.
Amen. Thank you, brother. That was a blessing. You know, it's a simple prayer, but it's our hearts. If it comes from your heart, it's never wrong, you know?
Yeah.
Jesus is Lord. Let me blow the shofar, and we'll end it.
I'll get mine, too.
What's up, brothers? Get your shofar, Brother Aaron. Woohoo! Double shofar blast.
I'm taking my earbuds out, brother.
Got 1 minute.
Here we go. Awesome. It never really comes out really good on these type of things, but you know that we're blowing them. You can hear the little sound in the background. At any rate, Brother Brian, Brother Aaron, and especially Brother Donnie, thank you for sharing. We're close, right? We're all close. We know that.
Yeah.
And come, Lord Jesus. So Brother John, Brother Brian, Brother Donnie, Brother John, watchman for that great day.
Don't forget about our little brother, Aaron.